हरि ओम।
हरि ओम संजय जी।
आर वी गुड टू गो?
यस संजय जी, वी आर गुड टू गो।
ओम सहनावतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै, तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। समस्तजनकल्याणी निरतं करुणामयं, नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। ॐ श्रीचिन्मय सद्गुरवे नमः। हरि ओम। जस्ट टू रिकैपिचुलेट द गणपति अथर्वशीर्षम्, वी हैड कम टू द बीज मंत्र ऑफ गणपति गणेश एंड द प्रिसेप्टर द ऋषि टोल्ड अस दैट व्हाट इज गणेश विद्या, दैट नॉलेज आफ्टर ऑब्टेनिंग विच नथिंग एल्स रिमेन्स टू बी नोन, or the last frontier of knowing is to become knowledge by ourselves. Till the time we obtain the knowledge, the subject of knowledge is different than the subject of the one who gains the knowledge. The frontier when the subject of knowledge, the process of knowing and the knower or the one who obtains the knowledge, when all of them become one, then nothing subsists except the knowledge itself. That knowledge called Vidya, which is possible by worshipping the Ganesha in the form that has been told to us in Atharvashirsham of Ganapati, wherein it is given that after we have purified our hearts, if we meditate upon the Ganapati with the constant consonance, the resonance of the Bija Mantra of Ganapati, which was given to us with the compassionate attitude by none else than the Rishi Ganaka, sa esha Ganesha Vidya Ganaka Rushin. He gave it us in a chanda called Nichrut Gayatri. So sa esha Ganesha Vidya Nichrut Gayatri Chandaha Ganapatir Devata. The deity that is to be meditated upon, the dhyanam has to be done upon the Ganapati with the Bija Mantra constantly reverberating in our mind, and the mind getting completely filled with the resonance of Om Ganganapataye Namaha. Om, we have already seen how the mantra has come. Om Gang, taken singly, neither Om nor Gang are alphabets. They are not alphabets. Ganapataye Namaha, Ganapataye is a word, meaningful word. A combination of alphabets giving a meaningful word in the mantra is Ganapataye. What it means is the one that is pronounced by the Vaikari, Ganapataye, is easier to understand because it is comprehensible by the human mind. That is why this Ganapataye is Ganapati in obvious form that we know of. The beautiful, joyous Ganapati with his Varnan, which is anyway going to come little later. That Ganapati is to be meditated upon first. Once the meditation of single-pointed mind of a purified heart becomes firm in its footing, then the same Ganapati slowly starts vacillating and disappearing and getting merged into his Apara Brahman, which is Om, not Om, Gang. Now the Ganesha is becoming from Ganapati, Gang. From Drushya Swarupa Sakara Saguna Ganapati, now becoming Saguna Nirakara Ganapati, Gam. If the meditation further goes and fructifies further, then it transcends even the Saguna Nirakara, and the Sagunata of Nirakara is completely transcended. So neither the Ganapati remains a Saguna, nor he remains a Sakara. What remains is again the Ganapati Tattvam, but in a Nirguna Nirakara form. When in Nirguna Nirakara form is there, the Bija Mantra's first pranava, Omkara, is realized, not pronounced. So realization of the Ganapati, that is into Saguna Sakara form, then into Saguna Nirakara form, and then into Nirguna Nirakara form is the progress of moving forward. The concept of Saguna Sakara, Saguna Nirakara, and Nirguna Nirakara is a vital concept in Hindu philosophy. We are going to get one mantra immediately after this, which is focusing specifically on this, and that is why this particular mantra, which is the Bija Mantra, which is kept constantly resonating. When will the mantra resonate in the mind? When it has been repeated to that much of time. What is the guarantee that it will reverberate in my mind? A simple analogy, that constant reverberation of a chinta called what will happen to me in my life is constantly reverberating in our mind because we are constantly doing chintanam of chinta. That is why it is called chinta. Although it is very close to chitta, chintanam and chinta, there is a difference. When we do the chintanam or mananam on the deity, it becomes chintanam. And when we do it on materialistic life, it becomes chinta. So we are already used to chintana, but in a wrong manner. Because we keep doing the anusandhanam, constantly repetition, what will happen to me, my life, my money, my children, my future. The same if it is directed towards this, then the resonance of this particular Bija Mantra shall start filling the voids that are left after other thoughts are thrown out. In other words, all the vrittis that are there in the chitta are to be subdued and a new vritti has to be formed. This vritti is Ganapatikara vritti, Ganeshakara vritti. Vrittis are supposed to be basically completely dwindled to rest. That is called yoga. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. But to do the nirodha, for annihilation of vritti, substitution of vritti is the first step. If the person is habituated to eating, addicting drugs, and suppose he says that I will stop eating addicting drugs provided you let me eat lots of sweets. Both are dangerous, but the less dangerous eating sweets than the addicting drugs. So we say that, fair enough, that is called, this technique is called Parisankhya Vidhi. Parisankhya Vidhi means substitution of bad by less bad. And the substitution of bad by good is remembering the Lord and substituting the material thinking by Lord's thinking. If this way the Ganesha is constantly reverberating in the mind with this Bija Mantra, and then this Bija Mantra should not become just a repetition of word. Mala to karme phire manva bhire jagamahi. Ye to sumirana nahi. This is not a sumiran. So Kabir Maharaj says, when I am taking the name of a Bija Mantra, the one who is the Bija Mantra, Ganapadir Devataha, that Devata has to come in front of me and none else should occupy my mind. My chitta should have only one vritti, which is Ganeshakara vritti, and that is what the Ganaka Rishi is trying to tell us. The question is, once somebody does this kind of meditation, what happens to him? Then the Atharva Shirsha says, Ekadantaya Vidmahe Vakratundaya Dhimahi Tanno Danti Prachodayat. Three parts are there in the mantra. Ekadantaya Vidmahe Vakratundaya Dhimahi and Tanno Danti Prachodayat. Three parts of Ganapatis are discussed, and all the three, each of them have a different functionality. Ekadantaya Vidmahe. Vid is to know. Vid is to know. Know the one with one single tusk. Ganesha has one single tusk. Two are there, but the second is broken. If you look at the Puranic stories, there are many stories about it, but each Purana is considered as a part of Shastra. It is not a storytelling. So anybody who reads Purana as a storytelling art, he is mistaken to the bad extent. The reason is, Arthavada means when anything has been exaggerated. There is a figure of speech in English called hyperbole. You exaggerate, you get convinced faster. If I tell somebody that there is a movie that you should watch, this statement will not make much difference in him. But if I say, watch a movie, you cannot afford to miss it. Immediately says, what is the name? This is called creating the Antakarana Shraddha. But Arthavad is very important in the sense that this current of flow, that the philosophy flowing below this particular narration of Arthavad can never be missed. So in Mahabharata, while the Mahabharata was being composed by Vyasa, after doing four Vedas, Veda Vyasa, we call them Veda Vyasa. Veda Vyasa Rishi Maharaj, when he wanted to write Mahabharata, he already had what he wanted to write in his mind, because he was Sumedha. His buddhi was so pragalbha that the Pratibha, it is called Pratibha, divine revelations already made Mahabharata in his mind. Now to write, he required equally competent person. And none else could do that job except Lord Ganesha. Why? He is the deity of what? Narration. Vacho vibhanti nikhila, whatever is there in the speech, because he is tam chatwari vakpadani. So when he agreed to write, the biggest problem was he cannot wait to fill the ink and then, you know, start on the next page, because the flow that was coming from Vyasa may not stop. So he decided to use one of his tusks by breaking it so that uninterrupted writing can happen. This is a story from the Purana. What is the philosophy behind the story? In order to have uninterrupted flow of Saraswati, it is the Ganesha who tells us that please break the Dvaita. Keep one tusk. Keep Ekeshwaravada. Keep Brahman. Keep Advaita as your principle. And use the other tusk, Dvaita, only for understanding whatever is being done in terms of Veda or Purana. So Shabda Pramana, you require Dvandva knowledge. But do not forget the Dvandva Atita, which is the Brahman. Another story is, Parshuram Maharaj came for the darshan of Shiva, and since the guardian at Shiva's place, because Shiva Maharaj was taking rest, it was Ganesha who said, you cannot enter. And Parshuram, knowing Jamtigni Putra, very, very angry, almost similar to Durvasa Rishi, he was so angry that he started fighting with Ganesha. Ganesha, being the omnipotent, what he did is he literally made Parshuram bite dust. In fact, he fell unconscious. But when he became conscious, he realized that he has to use the final astra, which was given by none else than Shiva himself. So he threw Shiva's axe to the Ganapati, and Ganesha, who is invincible, would have remained invincible, but his father himself, Shiva, being his guru, guru's astra the Shishya cannot defend. And that is why he took that astra on his one tusk, and that is how the tusk was cut. That is another story. What is important is, if there is nothing that you can do in this world, if something with human strength comes across you as a jiva, then the only way to defend yourself is to break the dvaita. And then the third story also is there, that being Ganesh Bhakta, with whom Ravana had such a close relation, Ravana himself requested Ganesha that, "I want, as a Bhakta, I want your tusk." Why? Because he wanted to make earrings for the beautiful women of Lanka. This is Arthavada. The meaning is, even if you are very high in your bhakti, as long as the blessings of God in the form of Siddhi and Ruddhi, if they are used for personal purpose, for the material purpose, then the entire sadhana is a waste. So Ekadanta, these are the stories behind it. But what is the philosophy behind the Ekadanta? Ekadanta is Ekameva Advitiya Brahman. He was in Dvandva. One of the Dvandva he has broken to pronounce to the world that Ekadantaya Vidmahe. Know the Advaita, know the Brahman. Ekadantaya Vidmahe. Know him. How do you know him? First, by Paroksha Jnana, by studying the scriptures, by Agama Jnana, by Shruti Jnana, by Paroksha Jnana, by Chaturdasha Vidyasthana Shastra Jnana. So Shastra Krupa has to be there. That is how you know Ekadanta exists, the Advaita exists, the Parabrahman is there. This is called Paroksha Jnana. Once your Paroksha Jnana is complete, then Vakratundaya Dhimahi. Now you have come to the Vakratunda. Now Ekadanta, you knew about it. You know that there is something called Brahman is existing. Now comes the sadhana part, Vakratunda. What is Vakratunda? Vakra is curved, everybody knows, or retrograde. Curving means coming back. Retrograde or curved. The one whose trunk is retrograde. What does that indicate? The one who is moving away from source. As long as you are with the source, there is saralata. There is no vakrata or kutilata. But whenever you get trapped in the material world, in the Vishwa, you start thinking yourself as a jiva, and you believe in dvaita, that is the time your marga has become vakra. And then the one who makes this Vakratunda as a straight, that is why we saw that the trunk of Ganapati, if it is a straight, that means this is indicative of Sushumna Nadi. We saw last time, left-sided, right-sided, the Moon Nadi and the Surya Nadi, the H and the T, the Pingala and Ida. But the Sushumna is a straight trunk. Straight trunk means one who is not into the deviation of Dvaita. There's another meaning has been given in Sanskrit of Vakratunda. Vak, Rat, Unda. Vak means vachan, speech. Rat, pleasure. Unda, flow. One who is enjoying the pleasures of vacha is Vakratunda. That means one who gets in a Ganesha Stuti, the Lord is always pleased because he is Vakratunda, Vakarata Unda. Vakratunda as a name of Ganapati also, because Ganapati has Sastra Nama. Sastra Namavali is already there. In Skanda Purana, amongst the 18 Puranas, which are part of the Shastras, Skanda Purana talks about Kashikanda. I'm sure everybody has heard of Skanda Purana, because one of the famous line of Skanda Purana which we heard from childhood was, Iti Sri Skanda Purane Reva Khande Satyanarayana Pujatam. Satyanarayana Puja comes from there. Actually, Skanda Purana is for Tirtha Mahatmya. All the Tirthas, Devatas, their Tirthas are described in Skanda Purana. In Skanda Purana, there is a Kashi Khanda. The present Kashi, which we have in India, is considered to be a blessed city of Lord. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa could actually see at Manikarnika Ghat Lord Shiva giving mantra in the ears of all the dead bodies that were brought for burning. And I'm not exaggerating. This is there in Ramakrishna Paramahansa's biography. So this Kashi, because Jnanam is there, Kashi Ati Iti Kashihi, that which is basking in the effulgence of knowledge is called Kashi. In that Kashi Khanda, there is, in Skanda Purana describes a Kashi Mandala. Kashi Mandala is, this city has 56 Ganapatis arranged in 7 concentric circles of 8 each. That means on each circle, 8 Ganeshas are sitting. In this, the third circle, the one Ganesha who sits there is called Vakratunda. In this 8 circles that I talked about, 7 circles, with 8 Ganapati each that I talked, in the center is called Dhundiraj. Again, it's a type of Ganapati. So this is where the Vakratunda name reference also comes. We also know that in case of Vakratunda, he has been referred for Dhimahi purpose. Dhimahi means may we attain. That is the literal translation of Dhimahi. Mahi, Dhihi, may we attain. Dhi is precursor root word for Buddhi also. Dhru, Dharana, Dharma, that is also coming from Dhi. But Dhi specifically, when it goes undergoes the altercation in grammar, what it means is attainment. So attainment is always of Buddhi. So attainment, may we attain you. Attain means may we become like you. When there is a desperate attempt being made by sadhaka to be one with the deity, it is called Dhimahi. That is why Dhiyo Yona Prachodayat. Dhi. We are talking about that buddhi which after obtaining the deity of Upasya Devata into the buddhi, he becomes one with it. It is also called Aham Graha Sadhana. We have in Dhanam, Pratika Dhanam. So similarly, we have Ahangraha Dhanam. Ahangraha, Shaligrame Vishnu Vasati, that is Pratika Upasana. Aham Vishnu, this is Ahangraha Upasana. The I am Vishnu, this is a advanced Upasana. So Dhimahi means, may we attend Vakratunda. Now the question is, Vidmahi Ekadantaya, Dhimahi Vakratundaya. What is the difference? One is understand Ved. Ved is understand. That means there is a knower. We will know Ekadanta. But in case of Vakratundaya Dhimahi, he will attend Vakratunda. So Ekadantaya Vidmahe, Vakratundaya Dhimahi, and then Tannodanti Prachodayat. Tanno tat naha. Naha means we. Sahana vavatu. Na is naha. We together. So tat naha tanno. Tanno danti. Danti means the one who is with tooth. That is one meaning of it. Second meaning is tad no the anti. Tad means that. No, the means repulsion or separation. Anti means at the end. The one who removes the separation at the end. What separation? Between the Jiva and the Shiva. Between the Jiva and the Brahma. Between the Kutastha and the Parabrahma. The one who reduces the separation and ultimately at the end makes it vanish. Ekatva Pradata. That means Brahma Sakshatkara Karta. So Tanno Danti. This is another meaning of Danti. Prachodayat. Pra means Prakarshena. In Sanskrit, Pra means Prakarshena. Predominance. With predominance, Chodayat. Chodana. The Dhatu is a Chodana. In fact, one of the definition of Dharma is a Chodana Lakshana Dharmaha. Jimini Maharaj has done this definition in Purva Mimamsa. Chodana means that which enlightens my dhi with a particular type of taint. It taints me, it colors my thought process. It colors my behavior. That which enlightens me to act in a particular manner, that is a chodana. The swabhavam described in Bhagavad Gita has a close relation to this chodana. I shall get a feeling to work in a particular manner, and the manner shall be absolutely in consonance with what the cosmos wants, which is nothing else but rutam. So chodana lakshana artha dharmaha, that is dharma's definition. And similarly, that enlightenment, that effulgence to get any particular thing in the dhi with full vigor is called tanno danti prachodayat. This prachodayat is there in Gayatri Mantra also. Prachodayat, prakarshena chodate, effulgence of the knowledge. Tanno danti, he danti, please enlighten my dhi in a manner whereby no enlightenment is any more left. Because I have come from two stations. My first station was Ekadantai Vidmahi. I tried to know the Lord, Ganesha. Vakratundaya Dhimahi. I have meditated upon the Vakratunda. And now I want to enter into a field where I do not even remember that there is Ekadanta, there is Vakratunda. Why? Danti Prachodayata. When Bhakta becomes Ganapati himself, there is no Akratunda, there is no Ekadanta, because Danti has Prachodayata. In other words, these three indicate three different things. One indicates the Saguna Sakara Rupa, which is Ekadanta. Vakratundaya Dhimai, meditation wala jo Rupa hai, that Rupa is Saguna Nirakara. And Tannodanti is Nirguna Nigraha. If at all there is some confusion about Saguna Sakar, Saguna Nirakar, and Nirguna Nirakar, we can take a very small and a fine example and we will immediately understand it. We all know we feel hungry. Can we describe hunger? We can describe it. We can describe it, but can we show hunger? Is there any form called hunger? No. Why? Because hunger is saguna nirakar. It has a quality, but it has no shape. When the hunger is there, I eat food. Food is what? Saguna sakar. Guna bhi hai, akar bhi hai, chapati, bhaji, jo bhi hai. Saguna sakar, so that means the nivrutti of hunger is because of the food. That means saguna nirakar ki nivrutti saguna sakar se hoti hai. Saguna sakar retires or propels us to go to saguna nirakar. And after going to saguna nirakar, it becomes easier to go to nirguna nirakar. Let's take another example. Suppose somebody who has never seen fire in his life, he has been shown a piece of wood and told that there is fire in this. He would say, "Oh, where is fire? I've never seen fire and there's no fire. This is wood." Why? Because fire is pre-existing in that wood, which he has not so far seen. Why? Because it has not been converted into fire as yet. So that means the fire is there in that, but it's available right now as Saguna Sakar. As he starts working on it, the same wood starts becoming warm. Because it becomes warm, he comes to know that perhaps there is a fire, but I still can't see it, but I can feel it. That means saguna niraka. And then when he is asked, "What did this fire do?" he will say, "It made me hot." Hot again is a saguna niraka. When all the attributes are gone, we reach to the nirguna niraka. So to reach the attribute-less state, nirguna nirakar avastha, we have to move from saguna sakar. Why? The Bhagavan says to Arjuna, "Arjuna, nirguna nirakar is one of the most difficult exercise to do. There are some who do that. In this world, there are some people who can eat raw wheat and digest it. But most of us, we require chapati." So similarly, Nirguna Nirakara is not difficult to digest, but very difficult to obtain. So we have to start from Saguna Sakar. And all that has been told by Ganapati Athar Shrisham as Ekadantaya Vigmahe. Once you complete that, Vankratundaya Dhimahi. And once you do both, then the dhi is established for a purpose of Tannodanti Prachodayat. My Shariram is a Saguna Sakara Rupa. Indriya Prana Mana Buddhi Chitta Ahankar is Saguna Nirakar. Karana Sharira Sukshma Sharira Saguna Nirakar. And beyond that, after these koshas are traversed, Nirguna Nirakar Atmatattvam. So this is how Saguna and Nirguna Puja all happens in one Ganapati. That is why Ganapati Athar Shirishi gives us scope to understand Nirguna Nirakar, Saguna Nirakar, Saguna Sakar. This quarrel of Saguna Nirguna has been very beautifully sorted out by Kabir Maharaj. He says, Thare Rang Mahal Me, Is Shahar Me, Ajare Hansa Bhai, Nirguna Raja Ne Sirguna Sej Sajai. Nirguna Raja Ne Saguna Sej Sirguna Saguna Sej Sajai. So this is the relation between Saguna. Nirguna Che Bheti Alo Saguna Sange. Tukaram Maharaj says, I came to meet the Nirgun with the help of Saguna. So this is very elaborately explained in the mantra which that we saw just now. Once we know this mantra, then what is the first part of the mantra? Ekadantaya Vidmahe and Vakratundaya Dhimahi. To know him and to meditate upon him, we need a shape or a quality. And that is why next mantra goes towards method of worshipping Lord Ganesha. Next mantra is entirely dedicated to Ganesha Puja. How to do Ganesha Puja? That is why he is described first as the description of. Why description? For any person, in order to know him, we ask, Unchi kitni hai? Jada kitna hai? Kya khata hai? Kaise dikhta hai? Why? You want to visualize. Visualization or extrapolation is the typical attribute of human beings. Prani matra cannot have that. A special attribute of buddhi is extrapolation on the foundation of what is known. So what is known to us? Two hands are known to me. Now I can extrapolate to have four hands. Possible. Ab do haath hi malum nahi hai. And do ka char ho sakta hai, this is not available with the animal kingdom. The only yoni where this extrapolation has been given, because that is why imagination is a gift given by God to us so that we can imagine him to come closer to him. We use the same imaginative faculty for material purposes and yet we achieve it because of imagination. But that achievement has got no meaning. So the achievement for the purpose for which this shariram is given to us, the purpose of this life, the purpose of this antakkarana buddhi is to make it as pure as possible so that I can extrapolate, use imagination for meditation or dhanam. Ekadantam chaturhastam. Now, we will see that every word in this mantra is ending with in dvitiya vibhakti. Ekadantam chaturhastam pashamam ankusham. That's accusative clause. Accusative, that is dvitiya vibhakti. Why? Because all these are basically ultimately going to end in evam dhyayatyo nityam. That mantra, evam dhyayatyo nityam, these are all dvitiyas attached to that mantra. So this, all this, one who remembers evam dhyayati, one who meditates upon, that is why this is going on. Ekadantam chaturhastam, ekadantam, one single consciousness. Ekameva advitiya nitya shuddha brahma. Ekadantam chaturhastam. Chaturhastam, four hands. Why four hands? How many avasthas are there? 3 avasthas are there. But there is a fourth avastha also called Turiya. Now, the fourth avastha is an avastha because first three are existing. When the first three don't exist, the fourth doesn't exist automatically. So, although it doesn't exist automatically, the fourth one has to be imagined because the three are existing. Sapna jagruta sushupti turiya. The word hast has come from han. Dhatu for hast is han. Han means marna, to hit, to kill. Hand is used for killing, beating somebody. Han. Ha ha, hanta, hanta. This is how we call it in Sanskrit. That means, oh, somebody is beating me, I'm dead. Hanta, hast. Han is to hanan karna. One who does this is called hasta. Then if it is hasta, ekadanta ke char hat kon se hai phir chatur hastam. To me killing, he is killing the four avasthas. He is helping us to kill the three, the fourth automatically gets killed. Either you say, I arrived in the fourth avastha as avasthat rayatita, or you say that all the four avasthas are no more existing. Why? In Brahman, nothing happens. Where is the avastha? Avastha indicates change or vikar. Brahman is vikarless. If vikarless, then how we can have fourth avastha? The fourth one was present or is present in relation to the first three, but definitely not otherwise. So one who helps us to kill or overcome all the four avasthas, that is why he has four hands. Pashamam, ekadantam, chaturastam, pashamam. Pash is noose. Noose is a thread which is basically used for tying. Usually animals are tied, that is why they are called pashu. One who is tied. But the real meaning of pashu is unenlightened jiva. That is why we are all pashus. And then who is Lord Shiva? Pashupati, the Lord of unenlightened jivas. Why? He is the one who takes care of us then, because we can't take care of our own, because we are pashus. We are in bandhana, avidya bandhana, moodha jiva. So unenlightened jiva is a pashu because he is tied by pasha. So pasha, pashu and Shiva, these three together form a very important philosophical branch called Shaiva Siddhanta. Pash is bond of illusion. Pashu is bonded in illusion. And Shiva is lord of the illusion. These three together form Pashupati Nath, Nath Sampradaya, Shaiva Siddhanta. There is a lot of importance for these three philosophies. Aparasambit, and these are different subjects. Pashamam Ankushadharinam. Now he has Ankusha. Many people consider Ankusha as an axe. Ankush is not axe. Ankush is goad. G-O-A-D, goading. Goading is whenever the elephant has to be shown a path. The mahout, the one who sits on the top, he uses this goading. It has a sharp thing like this, and this it has a curved metallic thing. Now, if you observe how the elephants are taken care of by these mouths, they don't injure the elephant. They don't injure. But they do give a prick, so that what happens? The elephant does not lose the track. See, the difference is Pashamam and Ankusham, there is a difference. Pashamam, tied and taken away. Ankusham, goaded for what? For the journey of Jiva. Whenever you are derelict in your duties, it is Ganesha who tells you, oh, I did a wrong thing. I shouldn't have done it. Toba, toba. We do this. This is done. This repentance is nothing else. Ganapati's Ashirvad. Don't commit a mistake. If at all we commit, then I should not repeat it. The one who avoids us from repetition is repentance. Paschata. Pascha, after, doesn't matter. But paschatap also is a kind of a blessing by Lord. That is why he goads us through the paschatap, repentance. So, ekadantam chaturhastam pashamam ankushadharinam. Now, pash is in the left hand and ankush is on the right hand. Why so? Because right hand is, or right side is supposed to be the stimulator side. So left hand, he has a pash because he's a punisher, and ankusha because he's a stimulator or the guide for going on the right track. Ekadantam chaturhastam pashamam ankushadharinam. Incidentally, out of the four hands, these pash on the left hand and the goad or the ankush on the right hand is on the back hands, not on the front hands. Why? Only when it is required, he uses from the backside. Otherwise, what are his front hands? The front hands are meant for blessing. How does he bless? Radam cha varadam. Radam means tusk, the broken tusk. Is called Radam. The one which was broken to write the Mahabharata, we saw the story. Radam. Varadam. Now see, Radam. Next word is Var plus Radam. Varadam. Radam, Varadam. Anupras has been achieved by Ganakurushi here. Alliteration. Even the figure of speech, Alankara Shastra is, Chanda is already used. This is the Nichrut Gayatri Chanda. Alankara is also used. That is why, if you see, there is a melody in the whole thing. Ekadantam chaturastam pashamam kushadharinam radam javaradam astaye pribranam ushakatujam rakta lambodaram rakta pushpushpushpush. It has a melody into it. Why? Because of alliteration, because of the words that are used. And yet the chanda is not disturbed. Radam chavaradam, the one who has a broken tusk in his hand, and he also has abhaya mudra. Abhaya mudra. The highest blessing that a God can give to mankind, or we can ask, is, which is constantly reverberating throughout entire Upanishad, is Nirbhaya. Bhi. No bhayam. There is nothing required in life except loss of fear. We want money, we want this, we want that. Everything that we want is for only one reason, that there is no, should not be any fear. That is why Kabir Maharaj says, Nirbhaya nirguna gunare gaunga. Moola kamalatala asana bandhoji. Sunna nisana fairaunga. Nirbhaya nirguna gunare gaunga. And why bhaya is there? Dvitiya advaya bhayam. Dvandva, dviti, dvait. Dvait is the reason. Two are there, then only the bhayam is there. When I am one, Brahman, where is the question? Because there is no second to be afraid of. Dvitiya advaya bhayam. And the one who gives akhand abhayavastha is Ganapati, because his right hand, front hand, is always in abhaya mudra. So that is why his description further goes. He says, hastaye bribhranam mushakadvajam. Hastaye, with the hands he is holding what? Bribhranam. Bribhranam, the dhatu is bru. Bru is to hold or to bear, holding, bestowing, holding. Mushakadvajam. He sits on the mushaka. Everyone knows that mushaka has been compared with the mind, which is going here and there. So he keeps the mind under control. How he keeps it under control? The tundila tanu, the so much of lambodaram that he has. Which, what is lambodaram? Gurudev rightly has described Ganesha in one of his pravachana. What he says? He says, multiplicity of forms and shapes. All this that has been created under the time and space bounds, and it is still growing. That is why lambodara. It is so huge that it is overflowing. Lamba udara. Lamba means straight and falling. Both the meanings are there. That means it is bigger and it is falling, means it's still growing. The ever increasing growth of the universe is being balanced by on the rat, on the mouse. Such a small thing called mind. Why? Because what is universe? Universe is what the mind holds. Whatever is not in the mind, it is not in the universe. Or in other words, what is the definition of universe? That which has been envisaged as universe by the mind. And since it is the mind which does this, it is the mind which is the root cause of everything, and it is the mind which is the source of emancipation. Mana eva manushyanam karanam bandha moksha yoho. Bandha moksha, dono, man se hi hota. If that is the case, then I have to work on the mind. How do I work on the mind? By keeping it under the control. In the entire creation, has to be balanced by that mouse, which is not running here and there, but steady. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. This is that mind, the mice which is now steady, absolutely nirodha vritti. And this, when it happens, then dvaja fairana, mushaka dvajam. Dvaja has come from the dhatu dhru. Dhru is to shake. Dhru means to shake. We have heard the word dhvani. Dhvani is one that shakes the tympanic membrane, the eardrum, is called dhvani. So dhu dhatu gives this dhvani, and aja. Aja means to propel or to move forward. Propel. I hope we remember Ishavasuktat ejati, tannejati. Brahma's description is given. It moves, it doesn't move. Kampayaman avastha. Vibrate is ejati. So dhu plus aja, shaking and propelling or kampanam, together it forms dvaja. Mushaka dvajam. That means this mind is one which he is holding as a flag in his hand. And that is how he is completely allowing us to have a full control on all the indriyas, because indriyas are subservient to mind. So davan labate jnanam sayatendriyaha. Sayatendriya, one who is having complete control on the senses. And manaha shashtani indriyani prakrutistani karshayate, that is also an indriya. So haste bribhranam mushaka dhujam raktalambodaram. Raktalambodaram. Slightly surprising. Lambodaram, fine. Raktalambodaram. Why raktalambodaram? Rakta is associated with Ganapati at many, many parts of this Upanishad. His color, red. Rakta gandhanu supujitam. Rakta gandha, raktavala. Rakta gandha together. So to understand that, you must know the dhatu of rakta is ruja. The French word ruja has come from Sanskrit, from Latin. Ruja. Ruja is rag. And that is why rang, Hindi word rang, also has come from the same. Rakta is the rajoguna pradarshit karne wala. That which announces predominantly rajoguna is rakta. That is why even when the rajoguna is at its peak, in pranaya, the lady is described as she was having raktima on her cheek. What is raktima? Because blood, we say, my blood was boiling. Rakta. Because every rajogunatmak action is bound to involve blood. Blood itself is nothing but rajogunatmak. Raj means red. And that is how rakta lambodaram. Lamba is large as well as hanging. This is as far as shabdartha is concerned. Now let us come to the lakshanartha. Ganesha has been the deity of tantrika upasakas also. In fact, any Ganesha with more than five heads is usually there for the tantric people. Not before, below five heads, the normal worshipping. More than five heads are usually used in tantric sadhana. We saw last time Yamala Tantra and other tantras. Anushtan Tantra is also there. The, from Kundalini Yoga point of view, we saw Tvam Muladhara Sthitosi Nityam. We already seen that. If Muladhara mein wo hai, to the Ra Bija Mantra of Kundalini, Ra is a Bija Mantra of Kundalini itself. Ra Aktam, Akta is to rise. Akta is to rise. The one who makes the Ra, that is Bija Mantra of Kundalini, means Kundalini to rise, is called Rakta. Rakta Lambodaram. He is that which makes the Kundalini rise. So Rakta can be understood or needs to be understood as the Lakshanartha as Kundalini Vidya, where it is the same Ganesha which makes the Kundalini rise from Muladhara Chakra upwards. So Rakta is understood. Then why Lambodaram? The reason why Lambodaram is also equally interesting. Whenever the Kundalini starts rising, the Muladhara Chakra is at a perineal level, almost close to the sacrum. It's close to the sacral plexus. When it starts rising that time, because of the movement of Kundalini, the vertebras are pushed forward. So something like lordosis happened. A lady, when she's pregnant, the way the spine gets curled forward in the similar manner for the yogi also in the initial period of Kundalini. It moves forward naturally. It kind of protrudes the abdomen. The tummy comes slightly out. That is why Rakta Lambodaram. Another meaning in Tantra Shastra of Lambodara is Lam Bodha Ra. Lambodha, Lambodha Ra. Lambodhara. Lam is what? We know Lam is the Bija Mantra of Muladhara Chakra. In fact, Lam, Vam, Ram, Yam, Om, Hum, and Om. Muladhara, Swadhisthan, Manipur, Anahat, Ajna Chakra, and the Sahasrara Chakra. All the chakras each have a Bija Mantra. The Bija Mantra of Muladhara Chakra, which is again under the deity of Ganapati, as a Bija Mantra, Lam. Lam, Bodha, Ra, Kundalini. So one who gives Bodha to the Kundalini to rise is Lambodha, Ra, Lambodara. So this is how the Lambodaram, Rakta Lambodaram is explained. Then Shurpakaranakam. Shurpa means, in English it is called winnowing fan. In Marathi it is called soup. And in Hindi we must have seen jo khaliyan mein jinhone dekha hoga, to clear the chaff from the wheat after the harvest, they use this soup where chaff is cleared from there. Jisko Hindi mein phatakna bolte hai. Dhan ko phatakte hai. So this is called Shurpa. Shurpa Karnakam. What is the Vachartha? The Karna are like the soup, supli, or soup, or winnowing fan. But what are the other meanings? One meaning is Shupa Karanaka. Shu means Shura, Pa means protect, Karanaka means doing. Protecting the brave and the wise in action. Who is brave and wise in action? Dhiraha. Who is Dhiraha? Dhiram Rati Grunhati Iti Dhiraha. The one who is trying to completely control his senses is called Dhira. Upanishad has replete with this word. Ishavasya Upanishad especially, every line at the mantra ends with the word Dhira. Enastad Vyatsa Shakchire. That is basically talking about Dhira. So this Dhira, one who gives Dhira to the Dhira, one who gives, protects the brave and wise, is Shurpakarna, Shurpakarna. Another thing is, two pelvis bones are like the winnowing fans. Like soup, the pelvis bones, being a doctor, I can understand it better, but if you could visualize the pelvis, and you might have seen the pelvis has two parts. It is like this. So this is Shurpa. Why this is given here? Because when the Muladhara Chakra Kundalini moves towards Swadhisthana Chakra, then the entire space here is apparently filled with the Kundalini Shakti. That is why one which has this power is called Shurpakarnakam. So it is filling area between sacrum to umbilicus when the Kundalini is moving up. So Shurpakarnakam, Raktavasasam. What is Raktavasasam? Red, Rakta red, we saw. Vasa. Vasa has three meanings in the Sanskrita. Vasansi Jirnani, we have already seen that Vasansi means cloth, covering, tunic. Another Vasa is Bhagavan ka Vasa yahan pe hai, dwelling. Third is Achha Vasa. Sugandham, perfume, or Sugandham. So Gandha, Vasatisthana, and the outer tunic. Three meanings are there for Vasa. So Rakta Vasasam, the one whose tunic is red. Vachartha. Ganpati ko hamesha lal kapde se hi karte. We are going to come to that also. Why lal lal sab? Kabir Maharaj to bahut aage gaye. He said about Ganesh ji, lal lal sab kahe, sabke palle lal. Gaath khol dekha nahi to yase bhaya kangal. Ganpati is there with everybody, but if you are not able to gaath khol dekha nahi. Lali meri lal ki jit dekhu ut lal. Lali dekhan main chali to main bhi ho gai lal. Ganpati, if you try to investigate, it will only end in you becoming Ganpati. That is why Rakta Vasasam, the cloth which is red in color, रेडर ड्वेलिंग, ये रेडर ड्वेलिंग क्या होता है? वसति स्थान, मूलाधार चक्र. मूलाधार चक्र इज पृथ्वी तत्व विच इज रेड इन कलर, दैट इज वेयर ही स्टेज. वाई? पृथ्वी तत्व मीन्स एवरीथिंग दैट इज बीइंग ऑपरेटेड इन द अर्थ और द यूनिवर्स इज बीइंग मॉनिटर्ड, सस्टेन्ड, डिस्ट्रॉयड. ब्रह्मा विष्णु महेश एकत्व प्रचिति इज गणपति. देन वॉट इज दिस गंध? वास मीन्स परफ्यूम ऑल्सो. वॉट इज दिस? Whenever, as per the dictates of Ganesha, Prithvi Tattva, Muladhara Chakra, if we work in this world, then the karma that we do is the karma that produces Sugandham everywhere. It is called Karma Pushpa Sugandham. Sukarma, Swakarma Kusuma Veera Toshalagi, Ganeshwar Maharaj says. The flower that the Lord needs is of Swakarma Kusuma, the flower of your action. So this flower of your action, Gurudeva's all karma was full of Sugandham. Why? Karma Pushpa Sugandham. So Rakta Vasasam has got three meanings. That cloth which is red, why do we put the red cloth? Because Rajogun hai, tabhi to kaam kar rahe. So whatever Rajogunatmak I am doing, because Sattvagun is without activity. Sattvaguna is for the peace, dhyanam. Abhi to main puja kar raha hu. This is puja of Ganapati. In puja, Rajoguna is there, full blown. So this full blown Rajoguna, if you remove, inside is Ganapati. Rakta vasasam. Rakta gandham anuliptangam. Rakta gandha anuliptangam. Rakta gandham anuliptangam. Rakta gandham. Fragrant red sandalwood paste anointed. Is the actual meaning. Vachartha is red sandalwood paint anointed. Rakta gandha. How can perfume be bloody perfume? Rakta gandha. Two aspects are there into it. There is a chandanam called Rakta chandan. People from Maharashtra are very much aware of it. Perhaps in the days of Ganakurushi, it was abundantly available. That chandanam has a faint smell, not like the sandalwood. However, it bleeds a red color and it is reddish in color also. Even in Maharashtra, even now it is used if you have a sprain or something like that. So Rakta Chandanam, the name of that wood is Rakta Chandan. That Rakta Chandana Lepankita Anuliptangam. Anuliptang, Anu means after. Liptangam means anointing, putting on the body. Angam, Anga Angi Sambandha we know. Angam means parts. Angi, I am the Angi. This is my hand, which is Anga. Hand is, my arm is Anga, I am Angi. My lower extremity, my feet are my Anga, I am Angi. So all Anga, they form one Angi. So Ganapati being Angi, each of his parts, which are the Chaturanga. Chaturanga means the legs, the arms, the head and the torso. These four are covered or anointed, lepam, lepanam of chandanam of rakta chandana category. Why? Red color has to come. Rajoguna dyotaka. Why so many conditions? Why red color this thing? We come to that. Because there is one more aspect still left. Which one? Rakta pushpaihi supujitam. Pushpa. Pushpa word has come from the dhatu push. The English push has also come from there through Latin. Push means to move forward, to thrive, to unfold. Pushpa supujitam, auspiciously worshipped. Rakta pushpaihi supujitam. Take red color flower, hibiscus, the most favorite flower of Lord Ganesha. Kyun? Lal rang ki devata hai, lal rang ke bhav hai. The bhav has to be taken into the mind level, then only the meditation can be helped. पूजा भी करनी है, पूजा के थ्रू मेडिटेशन ध्यानम भी करना है. सो एवरीथिंग हैज टू, हाउ डू वी इन कॉमन पार्लांस व्हेनेवर वी ट्राई टू डिक आवरसेल्व्स टू गो फॉर समथिंग, व्हाट वी से, ओ यू आर थिन, यू नो, डोंट हैव दिस स्ट्राइप्स, दोस स्ट्राइप्स लुक बेटर, द कलर दिस लुक्स बेटर ऑन यू, इवन ऑन अ मॉर्टल फ्रेम लाइक आवर बॉडी. इफ वी थिंक सो मच, देन द लॉर्ड्स बॉडी हैज टू बी थॉट इन द प्रॉपर मैनर. And in my case, I know what is looking good for me or bad for me. It is relative. But for Rishis, in the Unmani Avastha, when they see this gods, they precisely know what the god wants. Why? Because the dharana is according to that. That is why we follow what they say. That is why it is established, and no one has ever questioned that. That is why when it comes to Lord Ganesha, he has to be auspiciously worshipped with red flowers, Rakta Gandham Liptangam, anointed with the red sandalwood, Rakta Vasasam. Even the red color cloth has to be put on him. This is called Deva Bhava relationship. Deva Bhava. What is Deva Bhava? Balakrishna, when you say, what comes in front of our eyes? Not that Lord who is playing the flute. Moment you say Balakrishna, Vatsalya Bhava. A small one, a small baby crawling on the earth with bluish tint, with mischievous smile, with butter in the mouth. So there is a akaram that comes in a particular manner. So if this is the case, then every Bhagwan, every Lord has to be worshipped in a particular manner with particular bhava. Now bhava, if you are worshipping Shiva, the one who destroys everything, now you don't have to go for actionable things. Rajoguna is of no, tamoguna. Masane me khele digambar holi. Bhoot pishachya batori. Masane me khele digambar holi. Tyag ka pratik hai. Everything has to be given up, destroyed. So what is the color? Ash color. Then what remains when everything is destroyed? Only the blue color, akasha. So blue color. So Shiva has to be of blue color. Ganapati cannot be blue color because you are still in sustenance phase, action, rajoguna. Vishnu, sattvaguna. Durga, red. Tamoguna. So that time, but in case of Saraswati, Saraswati, sattvaguna. Yakundendu tusharahara dhavala ya shubhra vastavata. Shubhra, sattvaguna. Then Vishnu, vivurvyapya, pitambaram, pita ambara, yellow. It has to be Vishnu, sustainer. Then immediately if it comes to that, Krishna. Krishna is what? Substratum of everything. Black color is the substratum of all the colors. It by itself does not show any color, but it allows all the colors to be present. That is Krishna. So that is how black or blue is the presentation of Krishna. Each Deva Bhava, then according to his flower. That is why sometimes it is sacrilegious to do something which is not fit for that particular god. Why? Because you have not taken proper attention. If your own child goes with a colorful dress on an official function, how will you feel? It is a dress, but it doesn't suit there. For a party, it suits. That means for every occasion, there can be so many nuances in mundane life. Then for the worship, one has to be, because it's an elaborate shodash upachara puja. You're going to do avahanam to Ganapati, and the Ganapati comes to know that he's not giving me my own costume that I need. He's not giving me the tunic that I ask. He's not giving me the flower that I need. If all this is properly followed, then what happens? Bhaktanu kampinam devam. Then the Lord will have anukampa upon you. The God who is compassionate to the devotees. Compassionate, bhaktanu kampinam. Companies tremble. When the trembling comes, when the bhakti, it is a sign of a merciful state. When the Lord is in full merciful state, that time he becomes bhaktanu kampinam devam. That is how the Lord's worship is happening. One or two, three more mantras are there, and then the worshipping pattern finishes, and the Lord's ashtanama starts. But before, Lord has to be worshipped in three stages. First Saguna Sakar, then Saguna Nirakar, and then Nirguna Nirakar. All that was given as attributes was for us to remember when we worship the Ganapati. So all these bhava has to be there. Bhava bale akale, iravi nakale, kartali avale te sari. Tukaram Maharaj, Nanishwar Maharaj says, bhava bale akale. Otherwise you can't get it. Just by dry knowledge, the Lord cannot come in our life. The heart has to be there. So Lord is to be read here, but felt here. So, buddhi and bhava. both has to go together. That is why Jnanottar Bhakti is there. What is Jnanottar Bhakti? After Jnana, the Prema. So Bhakti and Prema are two sides of the same coin. So whenever we are standing in front of Lord Ganesha, unless the Bhava is there, puja cannot be complete. But to inculcate the Bhava, remembering these attributes of Ganapati are going to be helpful. And who is telling it? Shruti. Upanishadas are telling it. Ganapati Atharva Upanishad is talking about it. Then Shabdam Pramanam. We have to follow whatever has been given by Ganaka Rishi. Hariyo. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnam Udachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.
Hari Om, Sanjay Ji, Manish. My brother had a question. I don't know. I think he is there still. So the question was that last time you were saying that whenever we look at Ganpati, we look at the trunk at the below level, and then we decide whether it is on the left side, right side, or it's going straight. But you said that it has to be looked on from the top, from where it is coming. Now, if you look from there, how do you come to know that in which direction this trunk is going? I'm not very clear on that.
If you look at this is the root of me. Now, I can have nose which goes to the left and again becomes straight. This happens. That is called deviated nasal septum. It can go to left and again become straight. So what has happened is, here it may look straight, but it has already curved in between. So the origin of the trunk, when it goes, it can come, the Ganapati's trunk can come from the origin and straight forward without any deviation, which is called straight trunk. It is only used for tantric sadhana or certain sushumna sadhanas. If this trunk has in the beginning itself moved towards right and then again become straight, it is still called right sided. So Vamamukhi or Dakshinamukhi is decided at the root of the trunk. As long as root is coming straight, that means it has not moved. Moment it turns or it becomes crooked or it becomes right or left, that is where we need to see whether it is right-sided or left-sided. The reason being, subsequently, because it is a long trunk, it may take an S form. Then what will you do? Will you take the down one or the middle one? The rule is origin of the trunk. And why origin of the trunk? It is expected that a Jivanta Devata like Ganapati, its origin, from where it originates, it indicates its nature. The Lord is moving his trunk which way is seen from the origin part. So hanging part may be anywhere. The origin part will tell you. As long as it is not turning anywhere, it is straight. Moment at the beginning, you see a first little left turn, and then again it becomes this side, it is left side. Hari. This is as per the Mudgala Purana.
Hari Om Sanjay Ji. Then in that case, when we are meditating upon Ganpati, which one is beneficial for us or which one is easy for us when we do the our meditation? Assuming that we are not doing any kind of, Kundalini Puja and all that. Yeah.
If you are not doing what ritualistic Kundalini Puja, etc., then we should be going always for the left-sided Ganpati. For the householders, it is the left-sided Ganapati because it is Chandranadi. Chandranadi is Sheetalanadi, Sthairyanadi. It is not Ugranadi, so everybody can do that and there are not many mistakes happen in that portion. But if you are doing it for the right-sided Ganapati, then what happens is most of them will have Suryanadi, which is a Prakopanadi, Tejanadi. If anything goes wrong, the person can suffer also. That is why most of the Tantrika Puja, Kundalini Puja, they all use that kind of thing.
Hariyo, thank you.
Sanjay Ji, just wanted to ask you, when I was very young, I had read some stories in Nandan. There was a series which talked about different colors of Lord Ganesha and different stories related to it. And they were, even though I was very younger, it was very nice, very mesmerizing. And each and every, there were many different shades and many different stories relating to it. Where can we find it now?
Yes, you can get, there are many books available on where all these different aspects of Ganesha have been described. There is one book which is written by Ramachandra Rao. I'm just showing you the book. It is called Ganesha. So this is one of the most kind of a scientific book, in the sense that it has taken all the stock of all the traditions of different colors, different types of Puranas which are talking about this, then different mantras that are there for, other than Ganapati Atharvashirsha mantra. There are so many mantras dedicated to it. Then in Kurma Purana, how much Skanda Purana, how much Ganapati has come, all that is there in this book. And also, once there was an attempt made about a couple of years back to make a small publication on Ganapati in Dubai. And with God's grace, I was given to write about that. I did write about it, and it is still in a typed form. I have it with me, but somehow the permission for printing was not given here, in which I have tried to give as much possible about these different aspects of Ganapati, including I have done a reproduction of pictures of Ganapati. One of the most beautiful collection of Ganapati was done by Wadayar, Chamundaraja Wadayar of Mysore. When he did that, he called all the painters all over the India, and whatever Ganapatis are existing, all were painted by him. That collection, and there is also one couple which is in France, who is a Ganesha Bhakta, they are French people. For last almost 45 years, every year twice they come to India in the search of Ganapati, and they have gone to the nooks and corners of Ganapati and collected the images. Luckily, I corresponded with them and got permission to reproduce those Ganapatis, which I have reproduced in that particular write-up which was done. It is still in printed form with me. I will hand it over to you. That will be my pleasure to give it to you. Maybe some of your queries will be answered there.
Thank you, Sanjay.